In this lesson, we will learn how we can connect data sources in Tableau. So we already installed Tableau. Now we will see how we can connect various data sources and how many sources are available. With that, we will also see how to get the data from an Excel file. Let's see. So with Tableau, we can easily connect over 100 data sources. But you would be wondering that from where we'll get our sample data which is perfect. So you don't need to worry about it. Okay, so when you'll open Tableau, you'll be having some sample data, okay, which is already placed on your system because you installed Tableau previously. When you'll open Tableau desktop, on the left you can see some options. So these data sources you can easily connect. We will see how we can connect and import a data source in Tableau. But before that, we will also understand this live and extract option. So when you'll open Tableau, you'll get this option on the top right. We'll see it later. So you will be getting an option to connect with live connections or data extracts. Okay, so let us see the difference between live and extract. Live connections, as the name suggests, includes real-time data. So if the data source will change, it will get immediately reflected in Tableau. Since it will provide the real-time data, the performance may get affected by the network speed and traffic. Then comes your data extracts. It is having faster performance because this mainly includes the snapshots of data optimized before. Okay. You can also access it offline because it is not a live connection and it is not real-time. Now, let us connect a data source. We will open Tableau and we will connect with the sample data. So, where you can find the sample data? On the left bottom, there are some saved data sources. One of the files we'll be accessing. And the file name is sample-superstore.xlx. I've also provided a link here. You can see under the documents, you'll be having a My Tableau repository. And within that, you'll be having a data sources folder and your XLS file, that is your Excel sample file, is available there. So let us open our Tableau after installing. So we already installed Tableau, and to open it, you can click on the desktop shortcut or you can also go to start and type Tableau. Since you installed it, will be visible here. You can open it from here, click open or click on the desktop shortcut. I'll click on the desktop shortcut. If you remember, we installed a trial version of Tableau, that is Tableau desktop. So you just need to click on continue trial now. And here is your Tableau. Okay. On the left, I already told you that you'll be having your Tableau file and Tableau server. So these are the data sources. You can connect your Tableau with Excel, even a text file, a JSON, even a PDF file, or even your geospatial data, that is spatial file. With that, you can also connect databases. I'll click more here, let's say. And here you can see all these databases you can easily connect. Okay, it also includes your MySQL, MongoDB, Oracle. I just clicked the escape key to close it. Now on the left, I told you already Tableau provided a sample superstore for you. Okay, so I'll open this. Before that, you can see quick start. Some pre-built templates are visible. You can check here. If you want to open your own Excel, you can click either here or either here, open a workbook. So this is the place wherein all your projects will be visible, Tableau. Okay, it will get listed here. These are the saved data sources. I already told you about the sample-superstore Excel file. You can directly click here and start, but I'll also show you the location. So I'll click here, Microsoft Excel. Okay, so here is the path, documents, my Tableau repository, data sources, version, and the following. Within that, you have your sample data set. Just click here and click open. Before that, I'll just copy this and I'll just paste it here. Press enter and here is your path. Okay, I told you C users, documents, Tableau repository, data sources. So this is our file XLS. I'll click here. Okay, so this was the path and the same file. Click here, click open. So guys, we opened our sample superstore Excel file. Here it's visible, and on the left, orders, people and returns are the tables, or you can say the sheets. It is empty here. You need to drag tables here to create a data model. So we will drag orders here. Okay. But here you can see data source is visible. So data source will have all these details. Sheet 1 is the place wherein we will create our view and work around Tableau later on. Okay. This is to create a new worksheet. This is to create a new dashboard. We will see all these things later. Okay. Right now, before moving the orders table here, I'll first check the sample superstore. So I hope you remember, this was our sample superstore. I'll open it. And this is our file. So this data is having ID, date also, order date, ship date, string also, that is ship mode, customer name, customer country, customer details, city, state, postal code, with that customer ID also. And I'll move for the region details, product ID, category, subcategory, product name, and other details related to sales and all. Here it is. Okay, sales quantity, discount profit. And herein we have our orders sheet. Then we have our people. And then the returns under the returns sheet. So we will drag the orders sheet. So this is having all the data types. Data type is a type of data that actually distinguishes your records. Okay, so we have date, numbers. Okay, numbers here. Postal code, we are also having string. So this is perfect. I'll click close. Now we will move the orders here. It's written drag tables. Let's see what will happen. And your orders table is visible here. I already told you about the live and extract. Okay, what is the difference? So connection is live right now. Live means real-time data. So these are the details. What I'll do, I'll just drag it here and it's written. There are around 10K rows. Okay, 21 fields, 21 columns here. And 100 of them are visible here. If you'll type, let's say 400 here, it will display 400 rows. If you'll type more than 10,000, let's say I'll type 12,000 and I'll press enter. Let's see what will happen. It will show you 10,000 only. So here in above the field name, your data type is visible. This is for string. Okay. Date. This is for string. ID. Number. Okay. I'll move forward. Okay, then again string and string. So this is your number data. That's why it's visible like this. Also, you can see the globe here. So this means your location, state, province, country, region, city, postal code. Okay. And it's also visible here on the left in the bottom, you can see. So these are the details, guys. We are under live connection. And it is asking us to go to the sheet 1 on its own. With that, the number of rows and columns in the table is also visible. I already told you. Okay, let's say I'll type 500 here and press enter. Now 500 rows will be visible here. Okay. Now 500 rows are visible. Okay, these are the options to sort the fields, I'll keep the default data source order. So these are the live and extract options. Already told you, live is real-time data and extract are snapshots of optimized data. Live is dependent on your network speed and traffic. That's it guys, we connected a data source. Okay, so we can also go to file and save our project, save as. When you click save as, it will get saved in the following location under workbooks. And remember, the extension would be .twb, Tableau workbook. We are not saving it right now, we will save it in our next lesson when we'll be starting with the sheet 1. Okay guys, so guys, we saw how we can connect a data source in Tableau. We connected our sample superstore file, it is already provided by Tableau. Thank you for watching the video.